I'm Frank Mickens. Get your news now on CBS 4.
It was a busy day in Washington. FBI Director James Comey paid a visit to Capitol Hill. This brutal cold's affecting the homeless in Indy as well. Metro Police still asking for donations now. Here we are at 5 a.m. and there's a whole lot of this morning. Ice on the sidewalk, ice on your parking lot, ice on the roads, and of course, ice on your car. I went to CBS the other day.
Did you pull out a receipt?
They just kept printing.
Exactly.
Kept printing.
Yes.
Kept printing.
It's
and
right.
I said, what is it?
Exactly.
They said it's a coupon. Warrior Morning at 5:13. Kim Jong-un arrived in Vietnam overnight, ready for the second summit with President Donald Trump. A gunfight between civilians and security forces in Mexico left 15 people dead. These headlines happening across the nation. We're going to go to California for this one. Multiple fires now are raging in Riverside County. Beginning your Wednesday with breaking news, a winter weather advisory, snow-covered roads, and dangers like this. This is a jackknife semi in Fishers. You're looking at a live in-dot camera.
Thank you all very much.
All right, so we're learning a little more detail now about what happened this morning when the call came in around 8:20 here at Dennis Intermediate School here in Richmond. Travel ban one, shot down. Travel ban two, again, shot down. This time it's a judge in Hawaii who put the brakes on the revised executive order. So what could be President Trump's next move? New information on this big fire at Race Trash Service in Plainfield. After 14 hours of fighting and monitoring the flames for flare-ups, crews were told it finally cleared the scene. But look at the damage on the inside. Piles of trash were set on fire, and the extreme weather made for some brutal working conditions for those first responders. A lot in our community doing what they can to help Hoosiers get out of this cold and into safe places. There are several warming shelters throughout our area. Our Charlene Cristobal, in fact, joins us live from one of those shelters in Kokomo. And Charlene, what are you seeing there right now?
I love that. That picture's one forever.
You love it because it's not
Keep
your
that
car.
Picture. It's last year.
With
they
the
tore
pumpkins.
Up your pumpkin.
One of our coworkers had a squirrel like break into his gas tank.
Survival instinct. The desperate search for survivors in the Bahamas is ongoing after Category 5 Hurricane Dorian wreaked havoc on the island nation. It just looks like a disaster zone all the way around. The death toll right now is at 45. They expect that to go higher. And let's take you across the nation now. We're going to start in Washington, where there is a dramatic police chase in Washington State. The driver of this Jeep Cherokee just took off. Well, there's a whole lot more to this story. They eventually bailed from the Jeep.
This shows the precarious position that these eight boys and their soccer coach have been in for 17 days with low oxygen underground. So this is where they're located. This is 2.5 miles away from where they went in 17 days ago. And notice now, to get back to where they started, they've got to go through one, two, at least three areas where water is getting trapped, which requires swimming. Well, the boys are not good swimmers. And then there's the low oxygen. They don't have hardly any food. That's why it's taking this long.
Right now, police in Columbus are asking for your help, solving a death dating back to September. They're asking if anyone can identify the man you see behind me. They want to hear from you. They think he's got information on that death. Officers need the public's assistance locating Alejandro Espinoza Ocampo.
Bluebell announced they're releasing their holiday flavor early. Really early.
It's going to be a long, limited time, though, because, I mean, we're still in October.
I'm here for it. I'm going to Walmart after this show.
You're not.
Ice cream is my jam.
But not that one. You don't want the Christmas one.
The school was expecting something to happen. So before even the gunfire happened, they had been put on alert. They were sitting in corners in their classroom. And I was asking them, okay, so were you crouched? Were you sheltering, like crouching over and bending over? They said, no, we were just sitting in the corner. And then they heard gunfire. And yes, certainly you're thinking, okay, what do you do in that moment? And one young man told me, only thing I could think to do was just text my mom. And hey, we've got kids, Bob. It's just unimaginable that you receive a text like that from your young person. This was terrifying.